12 volt starter.
But it came that way, didn't it?
We changed the radiator, the starter, the alternator, timer inside there. That made a real big difference, and it works real well now with a new timer. And that was a very reasonable thing to buy. We bought a new radiator, we reupholstered it, new tires. This side has the alternator.
Is that unveiling?
It's a gear-driven alternator, which is something a little more rare. Every spark plug has a coil. There are coils in back. We carry a new coil with us all the time because they do go out. Fan belt is a flat belt, something a little more unusual. The oiling on it, of course, is splash. So all there is a little dip in the pan. There is not a pressure oiling. The other side, this is a new radiator on here. That was something that helped us a lot because they always leak before. This side has a new starter on it, which is, well, oh yeah, okay. This, we should have a gasket or something in there, I guess. We used to have a water pump on it, but it gave us a lot of problem, and it always leaked. So we just ran thermal siphon like the old John Deere tractors. So there is no water pump, it just circulates by itself, and it does work. And of course, this is a starter which is not common, and does work very well. The horn is not the old one. We're going to try and get the original horn yet. I have a lot of them I have to rebuild.
Oh,
and we're
going to
find
cool.
the old horn yet.
So how, I'm going to ask a dumb question. Since this is a different starter, how did they used to start the vehicles?
The same thing. There was
same
a 6-volt.
Okay.
There was 6-volt. This is 12-volt. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. You can buy anything for this vehicle. If you need a new fender, there is companies that build every part for this car.
Isn't that wonderful?
Every part. If you need a windshield, they make it. This, of course, is your wiper, and this, of course, is your for defroster.
And some vehicles way back never had that.
Well,
they didn't have a windshield, and they didn't have a windshield. From what I was told, and how I never saw
yes.
them.
Yes. But the vehicle, like I said, was willed to her daughter. Her family, actually, her first husband, they bought this around Forestville somewhere, and it was painted red then, and that's why we kept it red.
Good.
Because Ford never made a red Model T.
I never knew that either. I just learned something.
Now, they made 15 million of them in black.
Wow.
There is no door on it, if you notice. Henry Ford only put one door on, and that's that side.
I did not know that either. So you had to crawl across.
This is the spark. This is our throttle. When you start it, you turn the key to battery, to that side, and you start it on battery, and then you turn it the other direction, and that's magneto. So, in other words, you don't need a battery to run it on magneto. It'll run by itself. The vehicle itself, the gas tank is underneath here.
Wow.
You put your finger in there, and that is your detection for the amount, since the only thing on the dash is a amp meter. Okay?
And look at those springs for the seat.
All right.
This
is the handbrake. When it's further ahead, that is, the handbrake is off, and when it's way ahead, that's high gear. That is low gear, the pedal on this side. The middle one is reverse. That one is your brake. You do have to adjust bands quite often. Parades are hard on them, and you're always constantly using low gear. And that, of course, we carry tools with us to do that all the time.
Makes sense. Because you're not real far away from home, but you must be, what, about 10 miles, something like that?
Yes, in that area.
That's a
But we'll put 100 miles on in a day.
I believe it.
It does work. And like I say, it has everything. We say starter and lights. But prior to this, when we say demountable rims, prior to this, you had to take the tire off on the axle. This car already has 4 bolts to take the rim off. Prior to that, you were fixing the tire either on it or taking the bearings right off and taking the whole wheel off.
A lot more work.
So this was a big improvement, demountable rims. And nobody thinks of that, but it's a hell of a lot easier.
Makes sense. The one good thing, if you look back in history, a car, a truck, anything that was made years ago is something that is fixable and repairable and always usable if you take care of it. It's not like the disposable everything that's manufactured now.
Yes. Yes. This is, like I said, we deal with Snyder, which is a company that has all the parts for Model T's and Model A's, the entire book. So if you need this running board, Snyder has it. If you need the back fender for this car, they have it. Now what they don't have is what I really want now is to put on a set of bows. And here they would attach, they'd lay back here, and it would hook into here on top, so we'd have a top. They want $2,000 for the bows, but they don't give you the covering for the bows. And that's something that would be very nice when it rains.
No, no lie, because you never know when something's going to pop up.
When it rains, we have a problem. We have an umbrella. I didn't even put it in today, but we have an umbrella that we need once in a while.
I was just going to say, maybe our little girl could answer that for us too, is why they are, I'm going to say an old term that a lot of people aren't familiar with, dressed to the nines today to be with the vehicle.
Well, today we went to the parade in Luxembourg, so that's why we dressed up. So we took the car and we dressed up for the parade.
And then you brought it over here to our parade of music. That was just cute. I just love it.
We're in Denmark.
That's great. And I hope we get to see this more and more. I have to ask, what does Reinke Equipment Incorporated do? And that's you belongs to you kids, right?
We started a corporation in 1960, and selling grain bins. In 1961, we started with clay equipment, and which is barn equipment. And we've been in that ever since. And right now, we have her grandson and 3 of my sons full-time in the business. We cover about half the state of Wisconsin with the feeding of robotic milking, doing the feeding. And of course, we do a lot of manure handling. One of my boys does just grain bins, and we do a lot of grain bins.
That's really marvelous. And I'm wondering how many people really know that you exist. We have to get the word out there for Reinke Equipment Incorporated. If you need anything, call them, because you never know what they may have or where they may steer you. A little pun here, steer you.
You got to remember when we have $172, which was Henry Ford's idea to lower the price, since he was building this Chevrolet, was getting ahead of him almost. And he just thought the lower the price, he will keep on going. He got stopped in 1927 and turned it to a Model A, which was a much better car. But that was his problem. He thought lower the price and keep selling them. And like I said, he made $15 million.
I was just going to say, but he had to stay in business, and that was the way to do it. Yeah. Sometimes you have to lower the price just to make it happen, even if you don't want to and you take a big nosedive. As long as you are alive and kicking, there is hope.
Yeah.
You know, and I mean, for any business, anybody doing anything. But I had to ask that because I kind of knew what you kids did, but I wanted you to get it out there so that a lot of people know what you have. Because I think the robotic milking is really becoming a huge thing.
Yes, it is.
With as many cows as so many of the farms have to be able to make a living, period.
When she turned 70, we bought a robotic milker so she didn't have to milk.
Really? Cool.
Yes, that was in 2002. And we ran that till 2006.
That's great.
Then we got rid of the cows and everything.
That makes sense. It's a lot of work. But, I mean, this is full-time. overtime all the time that you're in the business doing this, so it's really a big help to all the farmers out there and probably a lot of other people that you're not even thinking about.
Very good.
I thank you very much for taking time to come out here and show us your beautiful vehicle and what this sells
for. We're going to change that to 101 now. It's 22 now. Over.
It doesn't seem like it, but many years keep
passing
by.
Hey, there's a little bit of rust, though.
Lots. It's original the way it was, and that you can see that, yes.
What are you going to do to fix that?
We could, but we're going to leave it that way, I guess.
The thing is, something like this would probably last for many, many years compared to the rust on the new vehicles when everything falls apart. I'm not exactly promoting the newer vehicles, but it's not like what this type of a truck and the cars, that they stood up to everything.
Yeah.
Well, one day we'll have bows on it. Like I said, they're gonna be in here, and it actually will come up and it'll be higher. When you look at a picture of one of these old vehicles, they have an extra lump in there that makes it pretty high.
The headroom in there.
Yes.
Especially
yes.
If you're wearing the hat.
That's right.
Oh, yes, and you're taller. Yeah,
right.
Oh, you guys are beautiful. I thank you very much. This was thankful for
is
so
she gonna,
many
I think
times.
She wants to show the boot here.
Oh, yes. How could we not?
That's where the battery is.
Oh.
And this is our brake for sure. It goes out and puts it behind there quite often.
What was this known as? I know Mama told me and I can't recall. Was that the rumble seat?
No, a rumble seat is different.
The rumble seat had a seat in it, yeah. And that was in the Model A's, the rumble seat.
Did anybody ever try sitting? I'm
well,
sure
yeah,
somebody did.
That's how
did.
This got broke a little bit.
Fingers.
Yes.
But, I mean, you can put a lot of stuff back here.
Yeah, that's our trunk.
This is what you tighten the bands with.
that's good.
That's the size for the bands, 15/16. And that, like I said, is done quite often. And of course.
He's going to show you that.
That is done right here with this, and that is adjusted. When you have to change bands, this plate comes off, and you change bands. And that's done quite often. These are the coils, one for every spark plug. And they give a problem. They're not perfect.
And these are real floorboards too that need to be removed fairly often. It looks like, right?
Yes. It's not a perfect machine. Now, if Henry Ford would have taken this and made this transmission, because that's the forerunner of the automatics, actually. If he would have made it automatic right in there, he would have been way ahead of everybody, because we're running this manually and it's all in the system here. And all he had to do was get it done hydraulically, which is the way the new transmissions are,
mm-hmm.
right inside.
Mm-hmm.
He had it. But
he would have had a winner.
He didn't like it when his son started the Model A. This is the choke, and you adjust the carburetor by turning that. Something you don't have anywhere today either.
No, not anymore.
And of course, air conditioning. All you got to do is turn that. Of course.
I remember years ago, Mama talking about when they went down, I think it was to Chicago to take Daddy to the Navy training base down there, and she was saying she didn't have a windshield, and she had to drive way back up north. And it was starting to snow, and you know, so I mean, at least you got a little bit of something there. So, thanks an awful lot, kids. Will we get another interview with you if I'm real nice? I hope.